3D surface charts, like the one we see here, help you to spot anomalies or outliers in your data. My name is Jason Morrell, and I want to show you how, when, and why to produce this type of chart. There's a number of ways to show the 3D surface chart. This is the conventional way, but you can also look at it in wireframe 3D surface, contour, or wireframe contour. There are benefits to using each of these depending on how your data is set up. Let's start at the beginning, and I'll show you how to create one. So on the rainfall data sheet, we have a range of data showing the monthly rainfall in Timbuktu across 12 months over a number of years. Now, the heaviest rainfall falls in months 1 and 2 and months 11 and 12. In the middle of the range, so months 5, 6 and 7, that contains the lowest rainfall throughout the year. Now, on your chart, that's going to show as kind of coming in from the edges down towards the middle, creating a valley in the middle. So the highest value is towards the edge, the lowest value is towards the middle. Over here, I've put in a value of 300, which if you look at the rest of the data is way out of range of the rest of the data. This is my outlier, okay? So it doesn't fit the normal range, doesn't fit the normal pattern of my data. And when we look at the chart, that's why we get the spike over here. This value is so different to the rest of the data, it really does stick out like a sore thumb. Now, whether somebody entered it wrong or whether there was a freakish amount of rain in that month, who knows? But when you see something like this, it rings the alarm bells and it gives you a chance to go and investigate and fix it if necessary. So back on our rainfall data, so I'm going to select the entire data range here. And then on the Insert tab, there's two ways to get to where you need to get to. Firstly, you can go to this icon here, looks like a web. This is all in the chart section. And this represents a surface or radar chart. Now the surface ones are like the three-dimensional representation of your data. The radar charts are like the two-dimensional representation of this data. Both serve the same purpose. They're both looking to identify the anomalies in your data. Now the other way you can get to this point is to go to the recommended charts, go to the All Charts tab, and come down to the surface category on the left. Now when you choose that, you'll see at the top there, the four main types of data I showed you before. So we have the 3D surface, the wireframe 3D surface, the contour, and the wireframe contour. So let's just choose one. You can always change your mind later. And I'm going to click OK. So this is the original contour chart. So this is what we start with. Because we chose the chart from the Insert tab, it gives us our own little window on the same sheet. If you want to show this on its own sheet, you just go to the Move Chart option at the top and choose New Sheet. Give it a name, whatever you want to call it, and click OK. I think for something this complex, probably having it on its own sheet is the best option here. If you look down the bottom, the legend is showing the various depths or the amount of rainfall per month. So the first category there is 0 to 50. Next one is 50 to 100. These are all millimeters. Next one is 100 to 150 and so on. So if you correspond the colors in the legend to the colors you see on the 3D surface chart, you can see the kind of gray areas along the edge is the high rainfall. The orange section in the middle is your low rainfall. And even if you just went by color, that's already telling you something. Because we have that outlier, it's created all these extra categories which wouldn't normally be there, but it has to extend the range to accommodate that data. If we were to go back to the original data and actually fix that, so let's say we found it was a typo. So back on the rainfall data, let's change this one back to maybe 130. When we go back to our 3D surface chart, the anomaly has now disappeared. The range down here has actually changed the number brackets a little bit for us as well. But everything now is in the same kind of range. If you want to switch the chart type to something else, under the Chart Tools Design tab, you can go to the Change Chart Type. Sticking with the surface, you can choose any one of the other three from the top there. You can also switch row and column, which shows the chart like this. Now for this particular chart, I don't think there's any advantage to doing that. And it's because the rainfall data, it has roughly the same amount of years as it does months. So you don't really gain a big advantage by switching it around. So let's go back to the chart. I'm going to actually switch that back. So switch the row and the column back to how it was. And other things you could do, you could label the axes. But obviously you've got your months 1 through to 12 here. So it might serve you to have a little label down here that says month number. Or, you know, years is pretty clear what that's doing. Maybe one thing you want to do for the years is to put these in reverse order. So have the oldest year at the back and have the most recent year at the front. Now to do that, we need the sidebar, which for me is already open. But if it wasn't open, all you've got to do is to double click somewhere on your chart to display this sidebar. Once you're in the sidebar, you go to the options at the top here. From here, you can actually access any of your chart elements. I'm going to go down to where it says depth series axis and click on the axis options just here. Now under axis options, there's one tick box that says series in reverse order. And if I click on that, it reverses the order of the years, put the oldest at the back and the most recent at the front. So again, if that serves any sort of purpose for you, that's an easy switch to make. There's not actually a lot of options you can change on a 3D surface chart. If you click the plus sign here, it'll give you a list. So it says, you know, do you want your axes on or off? Do you want to put some axis titles on there, axis labels, the chart title, the grid lines, and the legend? So it's all really basic stuff. At the top here, there are four chart styles to choose from. So these give you different background colors and designs. There's also the quick layouts, which gives you various combinations of grid lines, data labels, all that kind of stuff there. So if one of these serves your needs better, you can switch these over fairly quickly and it saves your hands to do things manually using the sidebar over here. So that's 3D surface charts. I hope that's been useful. It was meant to be a very quick run through of what's available and how to create them and also why to create them. Let me know what you think and I'll see you for the next one.